Dear all, welcome to the playlist of Power System Protection. In this session, I will be discussing classification of protective relays. Actually, protective relays can be classified based on the following criteria. Number one, depending on technology used for construction. Second one is speed of operation. Third one is generation of development. And finally, based upon the function. So these are the classification criteria. I would like to discuss how do you classify protective relay based on each criteria. Let us have a brief discussion. In fact, depending on technology used, the protective relay can be classified into electromechanical relay, okay, based on the electromechanical phenomenon. So you need to understand the electromechanical property, then static relay and numerical relay. Let's understand what do you mean by electromechanical relay. Electromechanical relay can be broadly divided into two types. One is electromagnetic relay and thermal relay. Electromechanical relay is a conventional type of relay. The construction is rugged. Okay, it's a rugged construction. And you need to know the magnetic effect of electricity. The working principle of electromagnetic relay are as follows. Number one, based on electromagnetic attraction principle. So you need to understand the difference between permanent magnet and temporary magnet. When a current is passed through a conductor, that conductor is becoming a magnet, actually temporary magnet. And another principle that is called electromagnetic induction. You can able to see the electromagnetic attraction principle. Look at this. So we have a core material, and your operating coil and restraining coils are being connected in the core, and we have the moving armature. Okay, armature is connected over the. And there is a spring control mechanism which is kept over there. So when the current is passing through this core part, that becomes magnet. So that we can able to say that the moving armature that will be attracted towards the core. At that time, the contacts, that is the position of the contact, is getting changed. It is directly activated to the trip circuit. If the magnitude of current is very much high, the thing is the attraction rate also will be more. So that trip circuit will be activated. Let us look at the thermal relay. It based on electrothermal effect, just like a heating effect. So heating effect of electricity, that's just exactly happening in case of your iron box which you are using in your household application. We have a core part, and there is a moving part is also available, the moving contact, then fixed contact. Clear? So current will be passing, either current or voltage that is going to pass through the coil, thereby the core is getting magnetized. So afterwards, the metal part will be directly attracted towards the core part. So there is a controlling mechanism which is available there. Okay, just like a movement, it will be helpful. This point will be helpful for the movement. Clear? Therefore, it will be activating the tripping circuit. Tripping circuit is getting energized. Suppose if the fault current is very much high, the performance also will be high. I mean, the attraction rate also will be very much high. So this is regarding thermal relay. If I talk about the induction type relay, it works similar as that of your energy meter. You must have seen the energy meter. Okay, so we can see two type of magnet. One is upper magnet, another one is lower magnet. The flux which is passing or flux which is connecting in the upper layer is upper magnet is phi 1, and the flux which is inducing in the lower layer is phi. So the difference in flux, so that will be connected to the aluminium disc. So based on the difference in flux, the aluminium disc is going to rotate. This aluminium disc is directly connected to the trip circuit, thereby trip circuit will be activated. So this is working based on induction principle, electromagnetic induction. Clear? Another one is the thermal relay. I just explained what is a thermal relay. Here we have a heating coil. Heating coil is connected to the current transformer. You can see heating coil is available, that is connected to current transformer. And there is a bimetallic strip. It is activated based on the heating effect. So based on the, if the temperature is very much high, the relay contact is getting activated. Thereby it is connected to the trip circuit. Clear? To the CT, that means this is for the measuring. Okay, CT for measuring purpose. We are using current transformer for the measuring purpose. Okay. So we can observe based on the excess of temperature, based on the whenever current or voltage is passing through the coil, that is getting activated, thereby temperature of the metal part is getting increased, that is connected with the tripping circuit. So this is the way the thermal relay is going to operate, similar to your iron box which you are going to use in your house. I'll be discussing in detail separately about thermal relay, electromagnetic induction relay in the coming lectures. Regarding the static relay, okay, here we need an electronic component. First of all, we need to use CT or PT. CT for measurement of current and PT for measurement of voltage. Clear? Then relaying quantity will be rectified. Relaying quantity may be varying quantity that is going to convert into fixed quantity by using a rectifier. We require an electronic interface such as rectifier. It converts the varying signal will be converted into fixed signal. Then it is directly fed to a relay measuring unit. Relay measuring unit will be identify the fixed quantity of signal. Thereby it is getting amplified. So some amplifier is to be designed. Afterwards it is connected to the output device, then finally connected to the trip circuit. Thereby trip circuit will be activated. So normally these blocks like a relay measuring unit, amplifier, output device, all are working under DC supply only. So we need a 12 or 24 volt supply, DC supply is required, 12 or 24 volt, okay. So this is regarding the static relay. Now I would like to discuss about numerical relay. So a numerical relay is basically operated based on the microprocessor or digital signal processor. The programming need to be done inside the microprocessor based on the user requirement. And we can able to see the segmentation like arithmetic and logical unit, memory, certain registers also there. For these things and coding and all this is required actually. Okay. So we need to code. We need to code according to what is our requirement. Based on that you have to code. Okay, prepare a program and program has to be burned inside the microprocessor. Oh, then we can able to say that CT for measurement of current and VT, voltage transformer for measurement of voltage. Then it is going to convert analog to digital converter, ADC. So analog to digital converter. So because microprocessor is a digital device, of course we need to convert analog to digital quantity. Then based on the program, program is going to operate. It receives the inputs are current and voltage. Based on that, a program is going to activate it. So based on the output, it decides whether relay need to be tripped or not. Tripping has to be done or not based on the program. So this type of protective relays are known as numerical type relay. Let me continue with the discussion. Depending on the speed of operation, instantaneous relay, time delay relay, then high speed relay, ultra high speed relay is also available based on the speed of operation. This you have to notice. Okay. Based on the generation of development, actually it's a electromechanical relay is also known as first generation relay because it is a first stage of development, a very conventional type of relay. Afterwards, electronic based relay has been developed, that is called second generation relay, that is actually static relay, and the third generation relay that includes numerical relay based on the microprocessor. Nowadays it is advancing with the microcontrollers actually. Okay, these are the relay based on the generation of development. So based on the function, relay can be divided as overcurrent, just for the overcurrent protection, then undervoltage relay for undervoltage protection, then impedance relay, V by I, voltage by current, okay, impedance relay. There are distance relays are available, then directional relay to prevent the reverse power flow, then under frequency relay. These are the sub-classification based on their functionality. Then based on the protective relay as comparators, you can use it as a protective relay as a comparator, single input comparator, then dual input comparator, and finally multi input comparator. These are the protective relay classification based on the comparator. So in this session I have mainly discussed about the classification of relay based on different criteria such as depending on technology used. So we have discussed about electromechanical relay, static relay and numerical relay, and we could able to discuss in brief. The detailed discussion will be done separately. I'll be making a separate video on that. Then afterwards, depending on the speed of operation, we have discussed four subclassification. Then based on the generation of development also, we have made a three subclassification. And based on the functionality, we made five subclassification. And comparator, the protective relay will act as a comparator based on the segmentation like a comparator. We can able to divide the protective relay into single input comparator, dual input comparator and a multi input comparator. So this is my reference textbook. I have collected the information based on the textbook. And if you are having any queries, you can put up in the comment box. Finally, thank you very much for watching this video.